Natalie Gauci.
There's a big cape backstage in my building.
I think it's that feather skirt. Is it the feather skirt come apart or what's happened, Nat?
Yes.
Are we having a costume moment here? Is she blowing out all the candles on your cake around there?
I don't think I did.
5 seconds and I'm coming to have a look. Okay, alright, now I'll have a look.
Turn it back, mate.
Natalie Gauci, ladies and gentlemen. Hey Natalie, congratulations. You just pulled off the biggest deal in Australia. That's fantastic. You look sensational.
Thank you.
There was a moment there, and now the both of you were hugging and everything else, and when they called your name, I genuinely thought I saw you sit there for a moment with your mouth open, not believing it had come true.
Well, I still can't believe it. It's one of those things where I think it's going to have to take at least a day to speak to you. We both worked really hard. I have a feeling it would have been very close to voting because Matt is absolutely fantastic. He's very talented and we really love working with each other, but in the show and we've learned so much and it's just very overwhelming, I think, at this point in time.
I bet you do. I think it might have come down to a little Melbourne-Sydney rivalry in the end there. There are more people that are fingers on the buttons in Melbourne, I think, than in Sydney. Is that right?
I don't know, but it just felt like a football game. Like, I was standing in the dressing room and I'm like, this just feels so familiar to me. And I'm like, oh, it's like kind of like being
in
a football match.
Like the football
all the time.
No, Dave, Bob was saying he thinks that the breakthrough moment for you was the big band. Breakthrough. Is that what you see? What was the moment for you where you figured this is within my reach?
I think because I've done jazz in the past and I've done big band, I've done a big band before. For me, that wasn't like a big breaking point. I think, it could have been because I felt like I kind of took ownership of the stage because I felt confident with that style of music. So that definitely is one that I reckon there's about 3 or 4 in the show that I felt like I was just growing.
Yeah, there are a few commitments along the way from here. You've got the tour that goes starts off in January. January, that's correct,
yes.
January. But what do you want to do with your music career from here? Where do you want to go?
Basically I write music and I've been writing music for quite a long time. Well, not that long, maybe about 5 years. And I feel that I could make a really good album, co-writing with people, having my own songs on an album, doing tours, pretty much what the wind is going to be doing. So
yeah.
I'm really excited.
She's actually already got an album.
She's very modern. So
she's going to call the Gauci, is it?
Yeah. I'm going to call my business the Gauci. Maybe not the album, but the business name will call the Gauci. But no, I kind of feel that at the moment it's just all a bit hazy, but I think the focus is definitely there, the vision is definitely there, and to have a record deal with Sony, BMD, just seems like a dream come true.
Okay, I'm going to start off with this. Let's take some questions from the floor. Anyone have some questions for Nat and Matt? Yes, ma'am.
Do you think it'll be hard getting back to reality?
Oh, for me? Oh, wait, yes. no, I think it'll be fine. I think, where I live, I think a lot of people sort of will respect you and they won't sort of, come up to you and but it's all good, like, I'm sort of sure with that, and people that enjoy that, I don't have to, give them time of day, so it's all good.
Well, Natalie, perhaps this is your new reality.
It doesn't feel like reality at all. It feels like I'm just dreaming and I haven't woken up yet.
Matt, do you talk about all the time about your stuff?
Sorry?
You talk about your stuff as in the musical style.
Yeah.
Can you describe your stuff? Because from what we've heard, your stuff's not just going to be Australia-wide success, it's going to be international. Because most of our winners over the years have always sort of smashed it in Australia, not really hit the international. From the boys at Cronulla Way are telling me that your stuff's more international.
I think, when you say international, it's more so like college rock, sort of like melodic rock scene sort of thing. It's and that's huge in the States. Like you go to UC Band like Copeland and Death Cab, that can make a full living from just being successful in one state of America. Like, because that's about the population of Australia.
straight. So these guys, they sort of do the whole university sort of gig scene and stuff, and they just get their rep up. And I think my music's sort of close to that, I guess. It's just sort of like an ambient, and I don't know, I think it's nice. I hope it's nice. I hope you guys enjoy it.
We already know that Matt's already Melbourne's best secret for a while now. Now, congratulations.
Thank you.
Yes.
Congratulations to you both. You were talking about the cake before, and a few of us in the media room, there was a bit of conspiracy theories because there was one cake for each of you with a photo, and congratulations, and Matt, yours was all cut up and we're all eating.
That's not very fair.
I don't
my cake, they should cut that cake.
Yeah, and Matt was left on the side. Was there any moments kind of leading up to the finale that you thought, you know, conspiracy theories that was kind of like where you were placed at the before they did the decision or the case thing? Because we were just laughing at it, really.
Did you serve a cake up before the
yeah.
Oh my goodness!
Yeah, it was mainly the media contingent that ate them, Matt, sorry.
Oh, really?
I don't think it was any conspiracy.
Questions? Alrighty, there's a special day happening tomorrow. It's, Go ahead.
Congratulations from everyone at the Hot 30. Matt, how much talcum powder did you need to get into those pants tonight?
That's ridiculous. That's not a joke. That's a good question, though. Thank you.
Yes?
Oh, Natalie, sorry. I just want to say it's probably the best birthday present you've ever received.
I would say yes, probably definitely the best birthday present. It's like when you have a birthday, you kind of think, oh yeah, another number, it doesn't really change anything, but this is going to change the rest of my life, so yes.
What will you be doing tomorrow?
Probably a lot of press. But I'm going to try and do something really special tomorrow night. Hopefully some of my family can stay in Sydney and have dinner and chill out.
Were you surprised to see your grandpa's here?
Oh my goodness, yes. Like my family mean the world to me, and I think they keep me grounded, and I need them with me all the time. And not having my grandparents here perhaps did upset me. And I said to my mum, well, if they're cool with staying home in Melbourne, then I'm cool with it. But I wasn't really. And then to see them on the stage, just really, I was overwhelmed by that. Yeah.
Are you-